And it came to pass,
okay,
when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into heaven,
the Bible says that it came to pass that the Lord was about to take Elijah to heaven.
Mm-hmm. By a whirlwind.
By a whirlwind, uh-huh.
That Elijah went with Elisha, uh-huh, from Gilgal.
Uh-huh.
Then Elijah said to Elisha, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me on to Bethel.
Stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me to where? Now, the Bible says that if you have your own Bible, you can circle the word Gilgal. Gilgal. You can circle it. The word Gilgal. Gilgal is a place of separation. As a matter of fact, the theme of my mercy is the journey for the power and the mantle. Tell the person behind you the journey for the power and the mantle.
The
tell the person behind you the journey for the power and the mantle. People of God, you know that Christianity is a journey.
Yes.
Christianity is a journey.
Yes.
And in the road of Christianity, there are a lot of things that you have to acquire. There are a lot of things that you have to learn. There are a lot of things that you have to know. Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible says that there was a great man of God. He was a major prophet of God. His name was called Elijah. Shout and say Elijah.
Elijah.
Or shout and say Elijah.
Elijah.
And God commissioned Elijah that he's about to take him to heaven. And Elijah was having an aide or a servant called Elisha. So during that time, the Bible says that, and Elijah said to Elisha, I want you to stay here because God has commissioned me to go to Gilgal. And Elisha said, no, I'm not leaving you. I want to go with you to Gilgal. And I said this thing, that Christianity is the journey. One thing that you have to put at the back of your mind is that when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, the first thing that you do is to separate yourself.
Yes.
Is to sanctify yourself, cleanse yourself, deny yourself. So the things you used to do, you do them no more.
Yes.
The place you used to go, you go that place where? No more. So the first thing that an individual, when you accept Christ, you have to understand that you have to separate yourself. The Bible says that we should not mingle ourselves with the unbelievers. So if you think you call yourself a Christian, then you have to know the people you have to glue yourself, the people you have to attach yourself, the people you have to move with. Somebody put your hands together for Jesus. So the Bible says that they started the journey from Gilgal, and now, so Elijah, when he told Elisha, God has commissioned me to go to Bethel. Then he said, no, Papa, I'm not leaving you. I'm not leaving you. So the Bible says that they left Gilgal and they came to Bethel. Bethel is a place of determination. As a matter of fact, after receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, the second thing that you do, because after sanctifying yourself, denying yourself, trying to live the ungodly life, the second thing that you need is determination. As a matter of fact, a lot of Christians, I was saying this thing in Old Town this morning, and I was saying to them that those days, in my country, they used to have a song that they sing, so one day Jesus they do, so one day Jesus they do. You know, and butter my bread, sugar my cocoa, so one day Jesus they do. Butter, welcome them, let them sit down, please come. Why are you sitting standing there? No, welcome them, please come and sit down, please. There are no chairs here. Yeah? So people thought that when they come to Christianity, things will be so smooth. Things will be so smooth. But they came to Christianity and now things become so rough. There are times some of you don't even understand yourself. He said, when I was in the world, man of God, I was enjoying myself. But now that I've accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior, now that I'm suffering. Mm-hmm. Oh, are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes. Yes.
There are times some of us, we mama, we cry, we complain, man of God. When I was in the world, things were so better. I was enjoying good life. But now that I've accepted Christ, things are hard. I'm suffering. And the problem of the Israelites was that anytime the Bible said they will confront Moses and they will say, hey, we were even enjoying ourselves. When you came to us that we should go to that land, that mountains, to worship God. Egypt was even better than where we are now. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
There are times we complain, there are times we murmur, there are times we say a lot of things that God, we have accepted you, but still things are bad. We have accepted you, but we are not enjoying a good life. Let me tell you something this night. The Bible says that many are the affliction of the righteous, but it's God who deliver him of all.
Amen.
I don't know your pain and your stress. I don't know the things you are passing through, but I believe there is a for you to say to yourself that I have the spirit of determination. Yeah. Whether good or bad, I'm still for God.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
The other day, the Bible said there was a woman called Ruth. Ruth said, Naomi, Mama Naomi, don't say to me that I should leave you, because your God shall be my God. Do you know, guess what? Do you know that Ruth knew nothing about God? Ruth did not know much about God. But the only thing is that anytime maybe Naomi and his husband, in the morning maybe they'll wake up and they'll begin to sing the hymns of God. So the Ruth realized that this God is a greater God. So we more by it, we believe in lesser gods, we believe in other gods. But I know that this kind of God is a strange God. This kind of God is a supreme God. And he don't say to me that I should leave you, because your God shall be my God. Whenever you die, I will die. I don't know where I'm going, but I believe in your God. If you believe in the name of the Lord, the Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower that the righteous and the right to enter, and they are safe. If you are going to put your trust in God, you will never disappoint you. The Bible says that God is not a man that should lie, nor a son of man that should take his man. Anything that God says that, he makes sure you are confident. Lift up your two hands and shout and say, it is true.
Amen.
You have to rely in the purpose and the ways of God. The other day, Balaam said, I want you even to die like the righteous. Ladies and gentlemen, your God is a living God. Tell the person behind you, your God is a living God.
God is a living God.
Tell the person behind you that your God is a living God.
God is a living God.
Or tell him or her that your God is a living God.
God is a living God.
Tell him or her that your God lives.
Your God lives.
Tell him that God, your God lives.
Your God lives.
Now, the Bible says that they left Gilgal to Bethel, and from Bethel, the Bible says that they went to another place. I want you to continue. Where you were reading, continue.
But Elisha said, As the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you.
I will not leave you. As the Lord lives and my soul lives, I will not leave you.
So they went down to Bethel.
And the Bible says that they went down to Bethel. Continue.
Now the sons of the prophets who were at Bethel.
The Bible says that the sons of the prophets, there are times when God is bringing a revival, there's going to be some people who rise up and talk about, even if you're a man of God, there's going to be a lot of men of God who rise up against you. There's going to be sometimes, even in your business, when you are emerging, when you are coming top, there is going to be an opposition against you. But let me tell you something. Oppositions, trials, critics and criticisms, they are leather help you to climb up. So when people talk about you, they are giving you a leather for you to climb up. I don't know you, but I believe that as they are criticizing you, God who's going to lift you up. If you believe it, shout and say yes. So don't worry when people are talking about you. Don't worry. There are 10 people who have to talk about you. There are 10 people who have to, question you. There are 10 people who have to sit down and gossip about you. You have to love when people are gossiping. Amen.
Amen.
It's an indication that you are climbing up to the top.
Yes.
Tell the person behind you that you are climbing to the top.
Yes.
Oh, tell him or her that you are climbing to the top.
Yes.
The Bible says that they reach where? You where are you now?
Now the son of the prophet came out to Elisha and said to him, you know that the Lord will take away your master from over you today?
Yeah.
And he said, yes, I know. Keep silent.
Mm-hmm. Tell the person behind you, keep silent.
Keep silent.
Tell him ahead, keep silent.
Keep silent.
Then I declare in your life that all the demons and those people talking about you, I bind your mouth in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said, I bind your mouth in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, you don't believe me? I said, I bind your mouth in Jesus' name. Try to mention your name. Hey, they will become stumbling.
Amen.
I command it shall be, it shall happen in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, you don't want it? I said it shall happen in Jesus' name.
Then Elijah said to him, Elisha, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me onto Jericho.
It was all this thing going on. Look at the scenario. And Elijah came to Elisha and said, son, it's better for you to live here. It's better for you to be here. You have to settle here. Because God has commissioned again, I want to go forward. And he said what?
But he said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you.
Mm-hmm.
So they came to Jericho.
And the Bible says that they went to Jericho. Jericho is a place of chamber. Jericho is a place you browse with God. A time has come and a season has come. I normally say that you have to know God for yourself. When you come here, this place is called emergency. Tell the person behind you, emergency. The emergency means, I actually believe that the Bible says that the effective fervent prayer of the righteous man availeth much.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, in Ghana, in my prayer meeting, when one of the members say emergency, they will shout and say testimony.
Yes.
Emergency.
Testimony.
Oh, good. Emergency.
Testimony.
Oh, those of you who shouted the testimony shall be your portion.
Yes.
Emergency.
Testimony.
Oh, emergency.
Testimony.
And you guess what? You know, in my meetings, Paul was doing so marvelous testimonies, miracles,
yes.
and great things was happening. You know, because the Bible says that they overcome them by the blood and the words of your testimony.
Yes.
I actually believe that God has to cause a testimony in your life. Tonight,
yes.
I'm going to open the floor before after the prayers, I'm going to, after the prophecy and everything, I'm going to open the floor. If you have a testimony, you're going to share it. Amen.
Yes.
It's good you have to testify. Because when you testify, God also what? Open another for you. Another for you. So when you have testimony and you had that testimony, the door will close.
Amen.
So when you have testimony, you have to testify about it so that God open another door for you. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
No. And the Bible says that they went to Jericho. Jericho is a place of chamber. It's a place you pray. It's a place you go, you shut down your doors and you go into your corridors or chamber and you begin to pray.
Yes.
A time has come that some of us, we have to forget about people. Some of you, when you have problem, instead of you to come to the house of God, instead of you to come and pray, you want to consult people, you want to tell your uncle, you want to tell your, you know, this is a little my eyes until the mountains. Man can never help you. The people who say, oh, tomorrow come, I'll give you some money, right? No problem, I'll give you some money. That same person, you go there tomorrow and say, oh no, I'm very sorry, you know, I should have given you that money. Oh my God. The Bible says, man will disappoint you.
Yes.
Curse is a man that trusts in man.
Yes.
But blessed is the man that trusts in God. If you believe that, shout and say, yes!
Yes!
So you have to put your trust in God. Chimba, tell the person behind you, chimba with God.
Chimba with God.
Browse with God.
Browse.
Oh, tell the person behind you, browse with God.
Browse with God.
Now continue from there. Continue from there.
Now the sons of the prophets who were at Jericho came to Elisha and said to him, You know that the Lord will take away your master from over you today?
Mm-hmm.
So he answered, yes, I know. Keep silent.
Mm-hmm.
Then Elijah said to him, stay here, please.
Mm-hmm.
For the Lord has sent me on to Jordan.
For the Lord has sent me to Jordan. Jordan is another stage which we call a place of action. Tell the person behind you, a place of action.
A place of action.
Now, this time around, enough is enough.
Yes.
We are not compromising with the devil.
No.
I said to my guys, I have this time around, no mercy for the cripple.
No.
When any enemy tries him, you will die before their time. I said they will die before their time.
Yes.
Shout and say, I said they will die before their time.
Yes.
I said they will die out. They will die before their time.
Yes.
They will die before their time.
Yes.
Shout and say yes.
Yes.
Oh, shout and say yes.
Yes.
You can go out. Maybe the person is coming here. That's why I said we should go out. Yeah. Maybe the person is coming here. Amen.
Amen.
They will die before their time. They will die before their time. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. So Jordan is a place of action. After the prayers, after everything, you have to take an action. Some of you are looking for a job. After everything, you have to present your resume to the company. You can't stay in your house and say, God, in the early days, you opened the floodgate of heaven and there was manna. And then you put a box there and said, I need a big money in this thing. I need it. Tell it, money, it won't come. Amen. Oh, tell the person, money won't come. You have to work on it. You have to move around. Because the Bible says that God is going to bless the works of our hand. The little thing that you do, he will bless it. Oh, are you hearing me, somebody? Because the Bible says that he made a man. He gave a man the power to obtain what? To possess wealth. God giving man the power to possess wealth. So when you try to do your best, God add it. God is going to add and going to multiply it. Amen.
Right.
Oh, amen.
Right.
We're going to pray this night. I am fed up with compromising with demons. I am fed up with giving away for these people. I don't know, but I know that you have something that is your heart desire. The Bible says that the desire of the righteous will not be cut off. You have a dream. You have something that you are believing God of. You are believing God for something positive. You are believing God that God should do something great. Ladies and gentlemen, if that thing will come to pass, then you have to pray. Yes. We are going to pray, and you are going to assess your life right now. And you are going to assess your life, and the politicians will say that, assess your life and cast your vote. You are going to assess your life, and you are going to cast what your vote. Yes. Now, if you see me pray like crazy, meaning that I want increase. I want to see thousands and thousands. If you see me pray here, then I want to see the answer. I want to see the hand of God down. If you see me pray here, that means that I am, because I'm not compromising with this image. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
So you can assess your life and you can look at your situation and you can pray. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
Oh, are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
Have you positioned yourself right now?
Yes.
Are you ready now?
Yes.
Okay. Open your Bible with me. Just be there. I'm giving you a quotation. Go and stand on it and pray. Ezekiel chapter 6, verse number 11. So that you know the relevance of this thing. Those of you that normally comes here, you know the way we pray. So you have to pray like crazy. Okay, Ezekiel chapter 6, verse 11. A good reader should help me out. Ezekiel 6, 11. Yeah. Read it.
Thus says the Lord God.
Uh-huh.
Pound your fists and stamp your feet and say.
Pound your what? Your hands. I love that she says that. Clap your hands. Tell the person behind you, clap your hands. Uh-huh. And then do what?
Stamp your feet.
And stamp your feet. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. And say. Alas. For all the evil.
For all the evil.
Abominations.
And abominations.
Of the house of Israel.
Of the house of Israel.
For they shall fall by the sword.
For they shall fall by the sword.
Sword.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Continue.
By famine. By pestilence.
As a matter of fact, as we clap our hands and tap our feet, it will be like a thunder against our enemies. Yeah. I want you to stand on your feet now. Come, stand on your feet, please. Are you ready now?
Yes.
The pastor should help me here. Are you ready now?
Yes.
We are about to fly. I want you to position yourself. Position yourself. We are about to fly now. Oh, pastor, please. Pastor, can you help me here? We are about to fly now. I have said something that I'm not compromising with these demons. Enough is enough. Shall they say enough is enough?
Enough is enough.
Shh, serious, mom. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
This night.
As I clap my hand.
I tap my feet. Any demon.
Any principality.
Hey!
Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus.
The Bible says the effective fervent prayer.
Yes.
Out of this praying for you, if you can pray this kind of prayer for 1 year,
yes,
you see the glory of God.
Amen.
You see a testimony.
Yes. Yes.
The reason why we call it emergency is that now when you go to the hospital, they have the emergency.
Yes.
And emergency, unless your situation is so critical, then they send you to emergency.
Yes.
Yes.
If you are an emergency doctor or a nurse, you have to be serious.
Yes.
That place is not a joke place.
Yes.
We're not joking, we're not playing. It's a serious matter.
Yes.
Because you came here, you have a dilemma, you have a problem that you need a change.
Yes.
Don't you need a change?
Yes, I need.
But don't you need a change?
I need it.
So the people who come here are people who need a miracle, who need a change, who want to see the manifestation, the glory, the shakana glory of God.
Yes. Yes.
Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
So I want you to position yourself. You have to be serious more, and we're going to pray.
Yes.
Now, open with me now the Bible. Matthew chapter 10, verse number 36. Matthew chapter 10, verse number 36. When somebody open there, you can read for me. Matthew chapter 10, verse number 36. Yeah. Okay, you can read it for me. Right, good. Matthew 10, verse 36, yeah.
And a man's enemies will be those of his own household.
The Bible says that a man's enemy shall be those of his household. The members of his household.
Yeah.
Now, do you know that Jesus Christ did a lot of miracles? But the Bible says that in his hometown, the Bible says that he did only few miracles.
Yes.
Have you ever think about this thing?
No.
There was a familiar spirit in his hometown.
Yes. Yes.
That was restricting Jesus.
Yes.
For him to penetrate.
Jesus.
There was a familiar spirit.
Yes.
I want you to lift one of your hands up like this. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any familiar spirit.
Any familiar spirit.
In my father's family.
In my father's family.
In my mother's family.
In my mother's family.
By fire.
By fire.
It's very good that anytime you are praying, you have to apply the Bible.
Yes.